Hello students, in this session we are going to discuss about database, schema and instances. At the beginning, we will discuss about database schema. What it means database schema? Design of a database is called as a database schema. So design of a database, so nothing but, so in which way we want to define or we want to design the database, that one will consider as a design of a database or structure of a database. So it represents logical view, not a physical view, logical view of entire database. It gives a rough idea about the database we have it in our memory, or we have to work with that particular database. A schema, the database schema, which contains schema objects like table, foreign key, primary key, views, columns, data types and stored structures, etc. So we can define the database schema in the form of the diagram. So in a grammatical form we can represent that one, or with the help of diagram we can represent that one. So while we are with the help of diagram, while we are explaining or while we are designing the database or schema, in that particular time we need to specify some database schema objects like a table name. Which one is the table name? For which one we are defining a database schema? So which one is the primary key in that one? Which one is the foreign key? So which one is the view? The column names and data types and stored procedure, all those elements like of schema we have to specify. Why we have to specify in a form of diagram? So database schema is designed designed by the database designers to help programmers whose software will interact with the database. Nothing but if we design or if we in a diagrammatical form, if we specify the database schema or structure of a database, in a sense, those who want to develop that particular database, any application with the help of that particular database, in that particular time, if we refer the database schema, we will get almost entire details of that particular database. Because of that one, we need a database schema. So we need we are categorized the entire schema depending upon some characteristics into a three categories: physical schema, logical schema and view schema. We'll discuss at the beginning the physical schema of that particular database. So what it means, physical schema can be used or can be defined as a design of a database at the physical level, nothing but, so to define the database, there are what number of memory we have to specify for that particular table or for that particular column, we have to specify in this particular schema. So with the help of physical schema, we will get entire details about the database, memory size, what the size of that one, all those details we will get from that particular physical schema. Second one, logical schema can be defined as a design of the database at the logical level. So if you want to know, so how many number of columns we have, what the size of that one, so what the constraint and all, we'll get from that particular logical schema. Next one, last one, view schema can be defined as a design of a database at the view level. So this one we'll consider as at the end of a user session. So here, in which particular format we want to define a database to the user, or if we want to display to the user, that one will be come under a user schema. Here we have one example. Suppose if you want to create a student database, in that particular time how we can categorize the schemas at the different levels into a different categories. So first one, physical level, nothing but physical schema. So here we will get the details about the physical storage of that particular data in terms of bytes, gigabytes and terabytes and all. Logical level, nothing but in a student database, how many number of columns we have, what the column name, so what the size we have specified, so primary key concept also we will get from a logical level. Next one, view level, a user. So if we are in a logical level, we know the column name and size of that one, but in a view level, user will not come to know what the column name, so where it is stored, in which particular storage it is stored, will not come to know. So only with the help of graphical users you want to access the database. So in that particular time we will get the details about what the GUI in a view level. So as in a we are discussed like we I told about database management system schema, we can represent it in a diagram. So this one is about that example for student database schema, course database schema, and procedures and sections and grade report schema. So in this particular diagram, we'll, by referring that one, we'll come to know what the schema name or table name. So how many number of columns we have, what the name of the first column, second column, third column, fourth column, similar way, we'll come to know which one is the primary key, which one is the foreign key, which one is the constraints, which and all constraints we are assigned for that particular table, we will get from this particular data scheme diagram. Next one, database management system instances. So in a database schema, we have a just rough structure of that one. So nothing but similar way, variable declaration in a database schema. Which value we are going to store in that particular variable, that one we will get it in a database instance. So because of that one, the data stored in a database at a particular moment of time is called as a instance of a database. So instance of a database, nothing but how many number of records are present in that particular database in this particular time. So in the, if we access the database and if we come to know we have 100 number of records, in the sense we can specify it as a 100 is a 100 number of instances we have it in our database. So if we want to give an example, in the sense, just imagine we have a student database, in this particular time we have 100 records. So that's why we can specify it as a 100 record or 100 instances are there in our table. After that one, so if we check again tomorrow, again after performing some set of insertion of a record, so just imagine 100 records again we have added extra. So previous one 100, again we have added 100 extra, that one becomes as 100 records in our table in this particular moment of time. So now if we check, or if you want to give a instances, how many number of instances are there in a particular table, in the sense 200 records are there or 200 instances. So by referring that one, we'll come to know each and every time as a time changes, the number of instances also get changes, because we can add an instance to a database or we can remove instances from a database. So depending upon the time, depending upon a situation, we will get a different number of instances for one particular database. So here in this session we are discussed about database schemas and database instances. In a schema, we will get a rough idea or the picture of a database, how we have designed a database in each and every different levels, like physical layer, in a conceptual layer, and in a user layer, we have designed a database, or we have to use a database in a different layer, how we have to use. So in a last database instance, we will come to know how many number of records are there in our database, that one is nothing but database instances. So this one is about database schema and database instances. Thank you.